Hey, Camping Nation, welcome to the show. This week we're going to be talking about how your insurance company might try and screw you over and what you can do to protect yourself and how bad they might try and do this. I'm Andy. This is We Love to Camp. Stay tuned. So as many of you remember, I sideswiped a parked van and did this kind of damage. The very following weekend, we went camping again, and the Geico representative came out, and honestly, I was impressed, and she made me feel comfortable. But that was before she tried to screw me. And this is how much she tried giving me. Of course, my $500 deductible, too.
I have roughly 70 miles to get to the dealership that I'm headed to. It's in West Alexandria. D&D. Hold on a second. So after gassing up with 10 gallons, that should get me there. Then when I get there and I drop off, I can go ahead and gas up and put a full tank of cheap stuff in there. I do have to make a slight detour first and go and pick up the travel trailer in Springfield. So I'll see you guys then. And we're just about ready. I gotta plug in my backup camera screen, monitor, whatever, and get out of here and then hit the road. And here we go, leaving it here. So after being with Geico for 29 years, matter of fact, it was 29 years on the 1st of July this year. So after all that time, I finally got a pretty decent claim here, decent size claim. And instead of taking care of me, you know, their customer, they're trying to pull the wool over my eyes. You saw the estimate. And you saw what they offered. When they offered that first check, this was before I went to D&D, before I went to the dealership. And when they did their own assessment at the campground and sent me, actually they sent El Presidente an email, they were very, very rushed to get you to take their offer. Hurry, click on this and cash it. Hurry, click this now, click this now. Hurry up and take it. Don't take their first offer. Ignore those emails. After 3 or 4 days, they said, okay, we'll mail you a check. I've got a check, it's in there in the kitchen. Do not cash it. Once you cash that check, or once you click on one of those e-checks, then you have settled for that amount. And it'll be like pulling teeth to get any more money, if you can get more money. So what I did is, after I knew that her quote wasn't gonna do it, I went ahead and got a hold of a dealer. I got on one of the local camping pages and asked for references for Central Ohio. And I did mention I was willing to drive a little ways. And we got word of a place out about 70, 75 miles west of here. And they have a good reputation. I looked them up. They had hardly anybody had any bad things to say. And when I talked to the lady on the phone, she was very friendly. And she told me that they try and get things in and out as fast as they can. And they don't like holding onto your campers for 6 months. That was a big thing. So they have it. They give us this estimate. And now all of a sudden, Geico won't return phone calls. It's a shame I'm going to have to fire Geico. It really is. 29 years. I don't know who I'm going to go with, but it's not going to be Geico. It's not going to be any of their other Geico under a different name, subsidiaries or whatever. You know, granted, on that first number, that 1800, that does not include the $500 out of my pocket for my deductible. So that's actually a $2,300 quote. But $2,300 will barely get a back wall and get it crated and shipped to you. I need that. The entire back wall needs replaced and the labor to install it, because I'm not doing it. If I had a shop big enough to put the camper in, I would. That would make a good video, wouldn't it? But not going to happen. Not going to do it in the alley. Yeah, that's not even including the silicone. That's not including the decals. That's not including the lights and the lenses that need replaced. The kitchen door that got damaged. The little black siding down the bottom. The stuff that flies off when you get into a blown tire situation. That's not including any of that. I ask you here, who do you have for your insurance? And this is actually my truck insurance. This is not the camper insurance. I can't remember who the camper is insured through, but since I was in traffic pulling the camper, then by Ohio law and most states, the insurance of the tow rig covers the towed vehicle. So Geico covers my truck, and then they inherently cover the camper when it's hooked up. And at first they tried saying something until I mentioned that. When I first called, I told them, said, yeah, I had an accident with the camper got damaged. 2018 Sunset Trails. They said, you don't have that insured through us. It was hooked to the truck, and that's state law, if I'm not mistaken. They're like, oh, yeah, you're right, we'll take care of you. But that's where we are now. We've already had to cancel 2 or 3 camping trips. We've got one coming up here in 2 weeks, I think. We're probably going to have to drive 70 miles out to go get the camper, then bring it back this way to where we're camping. And it's going to be a 10-day trip. It's a local trip. We're commuting to work from the campgrounds. But nonetheless, we've already got that scheduled, paid for, and you know, we're itching to get back in the camper right now, honestly. So then after we get done camping, I've got to clean it out and take it back out to them. Once they start ordering parts and stuff, they don't like letting the campers go. They like collateral almost. But that's where we stand on this. And as soon as anything happens, you know, I'll be posting things about it. And just not happy about the situation at all. I need to contact the company that whose van I hit and make sure that Geico took care of them. Even though I'm sure the van got totaled out, I want to make sure they got a decent number and they were able to either replace the bumper or replace the van. I'd hate to think that they got screwed over because of my insurance, especially considering it's they help the needy in town. I think it's called the Help House or something like that. So I guess that's going to be it for this week. Like I said, drop comments. Tell me who you're insured with. Tell me if you've ever had to make a claim through them and if you had good results or if they tried screwing you over. And any other comments, advice, insurance agents watching, tell me what you think I should do. And tell me why I shouldn't fire them after this. They're just not representing me, period. So hopefully I'll have an episode next week. I don't even know if I'm going to have one, honestly. I know I got a couple shorts that are going to go up, and hopefully you guys are watching those also. And I've got a funny one. I think I got an informative one coming up too. I'll try and get an episode up on Monday. But right now, I question that. So either way, if we don't see you in the campgrounds, we'll see you in the comments. Take it easy.